Hello students, in our unit number 11, alcohols, phenols and ether. In last sessions, we start with a new topic is a preparations of alcohols. And under the title of preparations of alcohols, we completed one process from alkenes. And under the titles of alkenes, there are two different methods. Number one method is a acidic hydration or acidic catalyzed hydration. So it's a direct hydration process, and this process is gone through or they obey the Marconico rule. And number two is called as an hydroboration oxidation reaction. So hydroboration oxidations, the reactions who gone through or would obey anti-Marconico rule. Now the another point is the preparations of alcohols from carbonyl compounds. Now the question is like that: what is the meaning of carbonyl compound? The meaning of carbonyl compound means carbon attached with oxygen with double bonds are called as in carbonyl compounds. So in the carbonyl compounds, so there are lots of functional groups under carbonyl compounds. As we know that aldehyde, number one, ketone, then carboxylic acid is the third one, 4, 5, 6 and 7, all are the derivatives of carboxylic acid, like ester, acid chloride, acid anhydride and amide. So we start to prepare alcohol from carbonyl compounds. So our the first point is the by reduction of aldehydes and ketones. Reductions means either we have to add a hydrogen or we have to remove oxygen. Both phenomena is simultaneously called as a reduction process. So in the reduction process, so aldehydes and ketones are reduced to the corresponding alcohols, because aldehyde and ketone, they reduce and they give the product alcohol by different reducing agent, like addition of hydrogen in presence of catalyst such as finally divided platinum, palladium, nickel, or it's a new one, it's a ruthenium. So this process is the addition process, because we know that in the case of aldehyde and ketone, they are having a double bond. So it means there is a presence of pi bond. So always they perform the reactions with the addition of hydrogen in presence of such type of catalyst. Then number two, either the hydrogenations is when we have to action of this sodium with ethanol. We know that this alcohol is little bit acidic in nature due to this H delta plus. So it definitely reacts with sodium and it's convert into C2H5ONa and they liberate hydrogen gas. So this hydrogen gas is a newborn hydrogen is called as a nascent hydrogen. So this nascent hydrogen which reduce aldehyde and ketone into alcohols. And next one is such a type of complex metal hydrides such as lithium aluminium hydride or sodium borohydride. The meaning of here, the hydrides means H-1. So they give the H-1 to the compound. So it's another reducing agent. So here in this portions, we have to go through three different types of reducing agent. Okay, when we perform these reactions, right, in the case of RCHO, when it reacts with hydrogen nickel or sodium ethanol or lithium aluminium hydride or sodium borohydride, simply RC double bond OH, so two hydrogen which can be added at first at carbon and remaining at OH, so it always gives a primary alcohol. Fine, because aldehyde is always at the terminal position, it means that your addition is always going through the terminal position, so primary alcohol at the terminal position. One example with aldehyde is like that, CH3CHO, acetaldehyde or ethanol. When it's hydrogenated with the help of either platinum or nickel or palladium or ruthenium, whatever the method that we have to use, so it's converted into ethanol, and we know that ethanol is a primary alcohol. The same way ketone is also react with such a type of reducing agent and it gives a secondary alcohol. We know that ketone always in the compound at the in a middle positions. Middle positions means in between positions. Ketone cannot be found at the terminal position. It means that the reduction of the carbonyl group, this carbonyl group in ketone, perform in a central position or middle position. So it always gives a secondary alcohol. So one example is like that. This is acetone or propane 2-1. So when hydrogenated with the help of such a type of reducing agent, so there is one, there is an addition of one hydrogen at here and addition of one hydrogen at here, because pi bond is broke or pi bond is shifting towards the oxygen, and the hydride process is performed on the propanone and is converted into propane 2-1. No mechanism is given in our textbook regarding to this concept, but for your informations, I give such a type of mechanism like that. With the help of sodium borohydride, mind well, this sodium borohydride in the case of Na plus and BH4 minus, and this BH4 minus is a very good hydride because in this case H minus is present. So it's a very good hydride generator, or they give the hydride ion to the another compound. So our step number one, R1C double bond OR2. This R1C double bond OR2 means it's a ketone compound when it reacts with BH4, but mind well, it's a minus in nature. So at that time, because we know that in the case of this C double bond O, so O is more electronegative. So this pi electron cloud is shifting toward to the, this O, O partially negative in charge. So it's a partially positive in charge. At that time, this hydride H minus is joined to this partially positive carbon, and we get a such a type of intermediate compound, or sometimes is called as an it's a one type of oxide formation, and BH3 is released. Now after the NaBH4, now this compound is reacts with a water. We know that H is partially positive in nature, so this H plus is attracted, or they lose the proton, and this proton is shifted to here step number 2, and we get such a type of alcohol. So our initial compound is a ketone, so definitely it's a secondary alcohol. So it's a very easy mechanism that we have to understand. So this is all about the by reductions with the help of aldehyde and ketone. Now we move to the another point, is the by reductions of COOH and esters. COOH means carboxylic acid and ester. So what in carboxylic acid and ester? So reduction of carboxylic acid. Likewise, for example, RC double bond OH. It's a carboxylic acid. When it's reducted with the help of, or the reduction of this with the help of lithium aluminium hydride. Sometimes, because for your information, very good reducing agent, or better with a B2H6. B2H6, as we know, that it's a diboron, gives a primary alcohol. Once again, in our textbook, they only give the such a type of idea, lithium aluminium hydride. But in the B2H6 in ether, right? It's a first step. It's a first one. And the second step is the hydrolysis with the help of H3O plus. Gives what? Gives primary alcohol. So it's a primary alcohol. This diboron is however not easily reduced functional groups, such as, because in the case of diboron, so with the help of this B2H6, they do not perform the reactions with such a type of ester or nitro compound or halo compound, right? So they do not reduce such a type of functional group. So it's a limitation of this diboron, but this diboron is very good, or it's a better compared to the lithium aluminium hydride. So in your competitive examinations, most of the questions they ask, why the carboxylic acid? or why this is better one, or why this diborane is not used for the, or which compound is not reduced with the help of diborane. So at that time we give the such a type of answers. Now the direct reductions, this direct reductions to the ester. Now our next point is R. This is all about the carboxylic acid, and now I give the example of ester. It's an ester, right? So in the case of ester, it's same way with the help of lithium aluminium hydride. It's a very good reducing agent. It's a very good reducing agent. So it's lithium aluminium hydride, and number two step is H3O plus, right? So it gives a primary alcohol RCH2OH. It's a primary alcohol, right? And plus RDS-OH is also a primary alcohol. For example, if I proceed with the example in the case of this carboxylic acid, if we perform the reactions with C6H5 C double bond O OH, it's a benzoic acid. The name of this compound is benzoic acid. When this benzoic acid is reduction with the help of lithium aluminium hydride, and number two step is H3O plus. So it gives what? So it gives benzyl alcohol. We know that this benzyl alcohol is primary in nature. So same way, if I perform the reactions of CH3, C double bond O, CH3. The name of this compound is methyl ethanoate. So this methyl ethanoate, same with the help of lithium aluminium hydride and then hydrolysis, acidic hydrolysis, it gives what? CH3, CH2OH plus methanol. So here CH3COOH plus CH3OH. So example of this carboxylic acid, so with the benzoic acid, and ester with this methyl ethanoate. So direct reductions of esters to alcohol can be achieved either with the lithium aluminium hydride, or sometimes we have to use in the case of ester we use a sodium plus ethanol too. This sodium plus ethanol is also used for the reduction of ester into alcohol, right? However, we know that this lithium aluminium hydride is being an expensive reagent. The lithium aluminium hydride, it's very expensive reagent. It is used for preparing special chemicals only. Commercially, acids are reduced to alcohol by first converting them into ester and followed by the reductions using hydrogen in presence of catalyst, usually at high temperature and pressure, or number two, sodium plus ethanol. So in modern days, okay, I give one more example. For example, nowadays, first they convert RCOOH with the help of alcohol. First they convert carboxylic acid into ester. And after ester, because in the case of ester, the performance of the ester into alcohol with the help of hydrogen, means it's a hydrogenation reactions with a special type of a catalyst at high temperature, or sodium plus ethanol is used. Why this route is preferred over the lithium aluminium hydride? Because sometimes, most of the case, lithium aluminium hydride being an expensive reagent, so it's used for preparing special chemicals only. So commercially, acids are reduced into its RCH2OH plus RDS-OH. Okay, I think so. It's a clear one. The reduction, okay, fine. Once again, if I give the example with CH3, CH2, CH2, C, double bond O, O, CH3. When it's reduction with the, it's a nascent hydrogen, which can be produced with the help of sodium plus ethanol. It's a nascent hydrogen. And this nascent hydrogen is reduced, this ester, into such a type of compound, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2OH, it's a butane one all, plus CH3OH. So the reductions, sorry, it's for your information, the reduction of aldehyde or ketone or esters, right, ester, with the help of sodium plus ethanol is commonly known as a Bouvet blank reduction. It's called as in Bouvet blank reduction, because in some examinations there's such a type of question is asked in your entrance examinations. In Bouvet blank reductions, which type of the agents are used? So at that time we have to give the answer of this sodium plus ethanol. So this is all about the reduction from the carbonyl compound. Now our next point is number three. In our textbook they given like that, it's from Grignard reagents. We already have an idea about who are Grignard reagents. First, we have to take a haloalkane. In presence of anhydrous ether, if we add a magnesium, so now the alkyl magnesium halide or aryl magnesium halide, the solution, suspended solutions in ether, is called as a Grignard reagent. So with the help of these Grignard reagents, definitely we convert aldehyde and ketones into alcohol process. So Grignard reagents are, what are the Grignard reagents? So Grignard reagents is either RMGX or ARMGX. What is the meaning of RMGX? It's called as an alkyl magnesium halide and it's an aryl magnesium halides. We know that in the case of Grignard reagent, so CMG, because the electronegativity of Mg is 1.2, carbon is 2.5, so inductive effect towards to this carbon, so this Grignard reagent is highly polar, because carbon is electronegative while magnesium is electropositive. Due to polar nature of this CMG bond, Grignard reagent serves as a, because that is a reason that it's a potential source of carbanions. So it's a very good source of carbanions. So this carbanion reacts with the aldehyde and ketones and ester to form alcohol in two steps. The first steps involves the nucleophilic attack of the Grignard reagent to the carbonyl group. For example, if I have such a type of carbonyl group, C double bond O. So this C double bond O, C is partially delta and this is partially negative in charge. It's a carbonyl compound. This carbonyl compound, when reacts with RMGX, so Mg is delta plus in nature, R is delta minus because it's a strong carbanion. In dry ether, if we perform this reaction in dry ether, so what the reactions can take place? This R minus is attracted towards to this partially positive, and at that time your pi bond is shifting towards to the oxygen. So we get an intermediate product, or this is an addition product, sometimes called as an addition product. And this addition product, the name of this is an addition product. So this addition product is now further hydrolyzed with the help of acidic hydrolysis, is gives what? COHR plus MgOHX. And this compound is called as an alcohol. And it's a basic magnesium halide. It's a basic magnesium halide. So it's a common, or it's a general equations for any type of carbonyl group. I mentioned earlier there, Grignard reagents is used to react with aldehydes, ketone and ester to form an alcohol in two steps. This is the first step. Is the first way, first you have to get addition product, and then the acidic hydrolysis gives a alcohol compound. Fine. So the first step, what is the meaning of this first step? This first step involves, it's an addition product, so it's called as a nucleophilic attack. And this, and the second step involves the hydrolysis of the adduct with water, or preferably with dilute hydrochloric acid or dilute H2SO4 solutions to form an alcohol. Okay, I give some more example about this Grignard reagents, about the Grignard reagents. If we perform the reactions with formaldehyde, if we perform the reactions with formaldehyde, so in the case of formaldehyde, in the case of formaldehyde, when it reacts with methyl magnesium bromide, here look, we are use a various type of Grignard reagent, either ethyl or methyl, methyl or isopropyl or propyl or phenyl, whatever the Grignard reagents that we have to use. So this is most important reactions. In the case of this aldehyde, is converted into primary alcohol. So what's the results that we have to observe? Because these reactions, if we perform in dry ether, right? So they gives right that HCHO. O is minus in nature. So minus is connected with this MgBr, and this carbanion is attached with this carbon. So we get an addition product. This is called as an addition product. And after the this addition product is hydrolyzed or acidic hydrolyzed, preferably dilute hydrochloric acid or dilute H2SO4. So it's converted into ethanol or primary alcohol. So what's the unique about these reactions? If we perform these reactions, because in the prior section, if formaldehyde is reduced with the help of H2Ni, H2PT, H2PD, or lithium aluminium hydride or sodium borohydride, they give same primary alcohol. But what's the difference that we have to observe here? Your reactant having a one carbon, and your end product is having a more than one carbon, because there is an addition of Grignard reagent with minimum one carbon is added. Okay, so that's a difference. Fine. So after this formaldehyde is converted into primary alcohol, I give one more example of a what about this is, because formaldehyde is a exceptional case in aldehyde, right? But except formaldehyde, whatever the aldehydes, right, or with the aldehydes other than formaldehyde, they form a secondary aldehyde. So the reaction is given like that: CH3 C double bond OH. The first reactions with formaldehyde. Now second reactions with acetaldehyde or any type of aldehyde. Acetaldehyde or any type of aldehyde. When it reacts with a methyl magnesium, for example, iodide in dry ether. We know that we get a such a type of product CH3CH here OMGI and CH3. So it's an addition product. Yes, we know that it's an addition product, because it's an addition of CH3 and addition of MgI. Now acidic hydrolyze gives, the product is like that. Acidic hydrolyze gives what? CH3CH. This is OH and CH3. So it's a propane toluol, and it's a secondary alcohol. Same way, In the case of ketone, any ketone, whatever the ketone, so here I as an example, I take a propane 2-on. Now this propane 2-on is reacted with a methyl magnesium bromide in dry ether, gives what? So it gives CH3CH3OMGBr and CH3. It's an addition product, and hydrolysis of this product is converted into CH3CCH3, here OH and CH3. So we get a tertiary alcohol. So in nutshell, the reactions of Grignard reagent with मीथेनॉल और फॉर्मल्डिहाइड प्रोड्यूस अ प्राइमरी अल्कोहल, विथ अदर एल्डिहाइड गिव्स सेकेंडरी अल्कोहल, एंड विथ कीटोन गिव्स व्हाट? सो इट्स गिव्स टर्शियरी अल्कोहल, राइट? सो वंस अगेन यू विल नोटिस दैट द रिएक्शंस प्रोड्यूस अ प्राइमरी अल्कोहल विथ मीथेनॉल, अ सेकेंडरी अल्कोहल विथ एनी अदर एल्डिहाइड्स, एंड टर्शियरी अल्कोहल विथ एनी कीटोन्स. So this is all about the process of the Grignard reagent. Thank you very much.